Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, we have a Sketchup Level 1 modeling challenge to help you hone your skills. Okay, so here's your first object to model. Your hint for this is Rectangle Tool. The way that I would go about making this is pressing R to pull up the rectangle tool, make a rectangle here, and then take the shape selected, P to push pull up, and use a line that goes across here. Select this face, P, again, a line, bring this up. Now the proportions aren't going to be exactly the same. I take this line, hit M to move it, but then hit Control to make a copy of it. Across, same thing, come over here. We have the basic shape there, and then come across here, you can go line like that. P to push pull, go all the way through. You can snap on this end to get there, and generally that's that shape. Here is your second shape. The hint for this one is Scale Tool. Okay, so the way that I would go about doing this one would be to make a rectangle or a square. Select the face, press P to push pull up, and select that face again, hit S to scale, and scale it in, holding control here so that it scales uniformly in all directions. And then use the offset tool to bring this in. Select that face, P to push pull. And then if you need to, like in this particular instance, it looks a little wider, just scale that in. Here's our third challenge. Your hint for this one is circles. Okay, so what I would do with this is I press C to bring up the circle tool. Take this guy, choose the center point, and move it to the middle here. Use the eraser tool, make sure nothing is selected. Eraser tool with E, select these two lines, delete them. Then use the offset command, offset in a little bit, delete the middle, select this outer face, P to push pull up. There we go. Here is the fourth shape for your challenge. My hint here is divide. Okay, so we have this shape here. The way that I went about doing this is I used the polygon tool, made sure it was set to 5 sides. You can see this has 5 sides. And then what I did is I extruded this all the way up, selected this face, hit M to move it all the way down to the bottom. But then what that allows me to do is to divide. So if you'd hit /5, you then get a bunch of different divisions. Actually, we need 6 here. And then you can select each of these and then hit S to scale. If you choose one of these edges, it allows you to scale in. And if you hold Control and Shift, scale that uniformly. And if you want it to look a little bit more like this, you just select it, bring it down, and there you go. This is the fifth and final shape in the challenge. Your tip for this is rotate. Okay, so the way that I would go about modeling this is you want to make sure you have the right amount of sides. So this circle here has 24 sides. Let's start with a circle and make sure that when I click that, it says 24 down here. And then you want to make sure you just snap to an axis because it makes it a little bit easier. So I press the right arrow key there to lock into the red axis. And then what I would do with this is scale it in. So you have this outer circle and then the inner circle here. Press L for the line tool and then draw a line from the center to the edge here. And then you can see it doesn't actually go all the way. You just want to check and see if it does. It's just very pertinent here in this particular case. So you just make sure that's a selection so that your line goes all the way to the end. And then I'm going to select this line, make sure I'm on the blue axis, and then hit Q to rotate. And then take this, and I'm just gonna hit Control to make a copy of that while I rotate, and then select this endpoint. Hit the asterisk symbol, you can see down the bottom right, the asterisk symbol shows up there, that says multiply. So I wanna type in 22. So that's the amount of sides. And then press E to bring up the eraser tool. Just get rid of these middle lines. And then every other one in here, I'm just gonna delete. Because we have a sunray with an equal amount of sides, we'll have an equal amount of parts here. If it was odd, this wouldn't work. So then you have your basic shape, and you just press P, and you extrude that up. Hopefully you guys liked this video. Let me know in the comments how you did. If any of these were too easy or too hard, I'd like to do a series of these of different levels to help you guys hone your skills. Let me know if you enjoyed it or if you didn't. Don't forget to subscribe if this was helpful, share this video with your friends, smash that like button, and as always, happy hacking.